Welcome to EPG Pathshala. My name is Dr. Neeraj Agarwal and I am Assistant Professor in University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management, Punjab University, Chandigarh. I am presenting lecture on module titled Garden Service. Under the paper titled Food and Beverage Service Operations and Management. After completing this module, the learners would be able to understand the concept of garden service, explain the types of garden service, define its advantages and disadvantages, perform the task for pre-preparation of garden service, prepare and serve items for garden trolley. Firstly, I will discuss the introduction. The garden service is known for its uniqueness in that food is partially prepared and finished in front of the guest. This kind of service demands highly skilled people to prepare, as well as in a restaurant, it would optimize revenue to the greater extent. This service is more personalized and guest-centric. Nowadays, this garden service style is found in a very few dining restaurants because of its cost factor and lean market segment. The history. The term garden is from French language. Not only the term garden, but the service style is also imported and extensively used in England. A garden was a piece of furniture that was found in French homes, similar to what we might call a sideboard. This would be positioned in the dining room of a home and would hold most of the equipments used at the table, that is crockery, cutlery, glassware, etc. Garden service was originally known as Russian service and involved serving large joints of meats, poultry, game and fish. This food would be displayed on a sideboard or side table, then carved or portioned by service staff, allowing guests to have as much as or little as they wished. During the 19th century, garden service becomes more popular, especially in more upmarkets established. By turn of the century, garden was an established part of fine dining. Nowadays, we find this fascinating style of service in rest of Europe and Western countries as well. Garden service may include several activities such as salad making, beverage mixing, meat carving, cheese offerings and flambing. It is considered that carving meat in front of the guest is the oldest act in garden service. Whereas the flambé dishes have become popular in the 19th century, it is claimed that the first flambé dish was crepe suzette served by Henri Carpentier at Café de Paris in Monte Carlo in 1894. Since then, a variety of dishes are flambéed to perfection and served. The definition. Garden means movable service table or movable side table. Any service that is offered from a trolley which is stationed near the guest table can be called as garden service. It comes in various forms nowadays, that is electric, gas, plain trolley or a small table. This service may involve finishing preparation of a dish, carving meat, filling fish or flambing. Now, we discuss the general points to be considered for introducing garden service. We must consider a few important points related to the decision of introducing it in an outlet. It helps the service is suitable to an outlet with the given infrastructure, its compatibility with present service design scenario. The following points would help in arriving to a conclusion. A great deal of coordination is required between both departments. In this service, the preparation trolley must move around the tables and a considerable amount of extra space is required in the restaurant. A clear and accurate market survey is required for potential guests as it still has a lean market segment. It requires special design of ventilation system. Keeping the trolley clean and hygienic all the time is a challenge. Consider safety while serving from the trolley. Now, I will discuss the advantages and disadvantages of the Garadhoo service. First, start with the advantages. It provides visual appeal to the guest. Preparing food besides the guest table attracts many observers. The aroma of the food stimulates the appetite of the other guest. It gives high quality impression. It gives the staff a chance to pay a personal attention to each table. Food is prepared and presented in the front of the guest. Showmanship can be performed with the service personnel. Guest can request as per desire up to the possibilities. Maximum interaction could give importance to the guest. It creates an effect of impulse selling. It can be a great marketing tool. Portion control and cost control is possible. It can make the atmosphere more luxurious and especially dining. It can increase profitability by increasing contribution margin of a dish. It would help presenting skills and creativity of staff members. It gives an opportunity to F&B service personnel to exhibit their skills and showmanship. Now, I will discuss the disadvantages of the Garadhoo service. It requires more space and special planning. It increases labor cost as it requires highly skilled persons. It takes long time to prepare and serve a dish. It requires a lot of efforts for innovation in recipes. Special attention is required on safety. The service is comparatively more expensive. Getting right ingredients would be difficult. It is not possible in all decors. The services are expensive because of the involvement of costlier cooking equipments. Now, we discuss about the various types of trolleys. The Garadhoo trolley. Different types of Garadhoo trolley are in existence for different purposes. They can be classified by the shape, design and purpose. Normally they have spirit burners or flambe trolleys. Portable gas burner lamp. The first, flat work top trolley. It is mainly used for making simple salads and serving cheese. It is a basic trolley with two levels. The top level is for preparation and presentation purpose, and the bottom level is to carry necessary crockery and bottles. Second, trolley with hot plate. This trolley has provision of a hot plate, which is used to keep the finished or to be finished food hot. Sometimes vegetables and potatoes are kept on the hot plate until service. This trolley cannot be used for flambing. Third, beverage serving trolley. As the name denotes, this trolley is extensively used for preparing drinks and cocktails. This is also called liquor trolley. This trolley has provision to hold bottles and glassware. The fourth, carving and presentation trolley. This is used for jointing or carving of meats. This trolley is equipped with a wooden carving board on worktop along with a set of carving knives. This can have hot case to hold the meat and vegetables. Meat is carved in front of the guest and presented. Fifth, flambe trolley. This trolley is mainly used to make sauces and flambe dishes. This is equipped with a flare lamp or gas burner and a bottle rack. Sixth, Adab trolley. This trolley is used to set Adab platters in an attractive way for easy identification by the guest. Seventh, Desert trolley. To portion and serve, desserts like lemon tart, a kind of dessert trolley is used. 8. Liqueur trolley. Only liqueurs are served from this trolley in a neat form. 9. Salad trolley. For health conscious people, a collection of ingredients are presented and are tossed as per requirement from this trolley. Now, I will discuss flaming and heating equipments. The first one is methyl spirit lamp. This is the traditional equipment used to cook or flambe the food. This lamp uses pure methyl alcohol as burning fuel. These lamps lost their popularity because of high maintenance and low safety factors. Second, fuel gel lamps or burners. These are second generation lamps used on Garadno trolleys. They have the advantages of occupying less space and low maintenance, but safety is still the concern. Third, the gas burners. They are much convenient to use in the restaurant. These lamps have no smell and no emission and are less messy. The flame can be controlled effectively. Gas canisters can be replaced under the burner with less efforts. This equipment has advantage of occupying less space and can hide under the platform, leaving a flat worktop. Fourth, hot plate. Various type of hot plates are available for use, for example, electrical, gas and induction. The main purpose is to keep food and crockery warm until service. Fifth, hot cases. These are mainly electrical, which are unplugged while the trolley is in movement. These cases are used to hold and maintain the large meats to be carved meat and vegetables at proper temperature. Now, flambing. Flambing is finishing a dish with a flaring by the addition of spirit or wine. Flambing enhances the taste, flavor, and appearance of a dish. Care must be taken while flambing, as it can cause serious fire accidents. The alcohol bottles must not be placed near the naked flame. Controlling of flame in the pan is very important. Flambing for long time may burn the dish and give unpleasant flavor. Short flambing leaves more alcohol, which ruins the actual palate. Now, we discuss about the tips for successful and safe Garadno work. Mise en place. Kitchen is asked to provide all mise en place, that is the preparation of ingredients for each Garadno menu items is complete. Second, equipment. All equipment should be kept clean and ready for service. Make sure Garadno trolley and all equipment is stable. Level of lamp should be checked before cooking. Third, space between tables, sideboard and restaurant. Decor and displays should be easy and safe for the movement of trolleys around the restaurant. Never pull a trolley, push it. Knives. Right knife should be used for the right job. Always use sharp knives and never cut on silver or stainless steel platter. A cutting or a chopping board to be used. Carrying knife with point to the floor position, knife safely on Garadno when not in use. Flaming and service. When flaming, spirits or liqueurs always pour into the pan from a port glass. Pouring directly from a bottle is not recommended, as the bottle might explode. Use service cloth to protect hands from heat. Don't flambe beneath a heat sensor or fire sprinkler. Clean up spills immediately. Work as a team of at least two. Personal. Hair should be kept tied back. Hair gel, hairspray is very flammable. Wear long-sleeved cotton clothing, less flammable than synthetic. Wear bow tie, not a standard tie, which can catch a light. Avoid inhaling cooking fumes, that is vinegar, lemon juice reduction. Cold liquids into hot pans cause splatters and spits. Another important is customer safety. Position Garadno at a safe distance from the customers. Be aware that butter and oil can burn and splatter customers. Warn customers when about to flame. Now, I will discuss items that can be offered from Gyarados trolley. All those items that one has an option of choosing from a wide variety can be offered from trolley, for example, cheese, fruits and wines. The dish preparations that creates visual appeal and wow effect can also be served from the trolley. Other and appetizers, meat and poultry, fish and seafood, dessert and sweets, condiments and accompaniments, sauces, garnishes, cheese and dairy products, fruits, salads, wines, spirits, coffees, patat pho, cigars. Now, I will explain the service point of the style. The Gyarados service is a combination of product preparation, presentation and restaurant service. Because of this reason, it requires highly efficient and skilled personnel with showmanship. The following are tips on the Gyarados style service. Always push the trolley but never pull it, as it helps in better control and stability. Avoid moving a fully loaded trolley. Always move the trolley towards the table and get the mise en place tray to load it. The Gyarados should not be moved while preparation. When more than two covers are served from Gyarados, only the main dish is presented from the trolley and vegetables and potatoes are served from the side station, as it helps in speedy service. The trolley must be stocked with appropriate service crockery. Cutlery must be arranged in the cutlery rack in a sequence that is easy to handle. Any dish served from the Gyarados trolley must be placed with appropriate cutlery. Factors that create impulse buying: showmanship, well presentation of dish, personal attention, attractive display, quality impression. By considering the above factors and careful practice, one should be able to tempt clientele to order something special for which they have not planned earlier. The Gyarados style service can catch the attention of guests and make them buy something extra. This successful impulse selling would earn high profits to establishments. Now, Gyarados setup. Top and under shelf of the trolley should be covered with a folded tablecloth. Most of the time, it depends on the nature of the trolley. Service and underplates, service cutlery, service spoons and fork, fish knives and forks, teaspoon, soup ladle, etc. Clean flare lamps filled with methylated spirit in old style trolleys. Clean sujet or flambe pans. Accompaniments depending on the dish. Service cloth, etc. Now, I will discuss various preparations on Gyarados trolley. The first one is crepe sujet. The ingredients required are corn flour, refined flour, egg, milk, butter, brown sugar, orange juice, orange zest, brandy and lemon halves. Equipments required are sujet pan, service gears, that is fork and spoon, decanters for brandy, china bowl for brown sugar, teaspoons, cutting board, dessert plate, dessert fork and spoon. Now, pre-preparation. The first step is make moderately thick pancakes using corn flour, egg and milk. Melt brown sugar in a pan and add orange juice to it. Add orange zest and pulp before bringing it to a boil. Reduce the content to a sauce consistency. Make thin strips of orange peel. Keep grape brandy in a bottle with pourer. Now, the preparation on the trolley. Heat a sujit pan and melt little butter. Add thin strips of orange peel and the sauce. Put the crepes into the pan and turn over once. When they are well coated with sauce, fold them into quarters with the help of a fork. Place the folded crepes on a serving plate in a layer. Add brandy to the remaining sauce in the pan and flambe it carefully. Pour over the pancakes and serve. The second dish we are discussing is how to prepare a peach flambe. The ingredients required are peach, butter, caster sugar, brown sugar, orange juice, orange zest, brandy, lemon halves. The equipments required are sujit pan, service gears, decanters, china bowl, and caster sugar, teaspoon, cutting board, dessert plate, dessert fork and spoon. The pre-preparation is take peaches stewed in a syrup. Keep peach brandy in a bottle with pourer. Now, preparation on the trolley. Take a shallow pan and heat caster sugar and brown sugar on low flame. Cook them until the sugar starts caramelizing. Add butter and mix well by keeping away the flame. Add orange juice and dissolve sugar. Add the stewed peaches and cook with reduced orange sauce. Then add brandy and flambe it. Serve on a dessert plate with orange sauce. The other dish which we are discussing here is banana flambe. The ingredients required are firmly ripe banana, butter, caster sugar, brown sugar, orange juice, orange zest, rum, lemon halves, and the equipment required are sujit pan, service gears, decanters, china bowls, brown sugar, caster sugar, teaspoon, cutting board, dessert plate, dessert forks and spoon. And the pre-preparation is take firmly ripe banana. Keep rum in a bottle with pourer. Now, we discuss about the preparation on the trolley. Take a shallow pan and heat caster sugar and brown sugar on low flame. Cook them until the sugar starts caramelizing. Add butter and mix well by keeping away the flame. Add the peeled and split banana and cook with reduced orange sauce. Then add rum and flambe it. Serve on a dessert plate with sauce. Now, we discuss about the preparation of rum omelette. The ingredients required are omelette, butter, chopped fruits, caster sugar, brown sugar, orange juice, orange zest, rum, lemon halves. Equipments required are sujit pan, service gears, decanters for rum, dessert plate, dessert fork and spoon. Pre-preparation is make a medium thick omelette with 2 eggs. You may add sugar but not salt. Keep chopped fruits in sugar syrup. Keep the bottle of rum with pourer. Preparation on the trolley. Heat the omelette on a sujit pan. Add caster sugar and measure of rum to it. Flambe it and then fold the chopped fruits into omelette. Present it on a dessert plate and serve immediately. Now, I will summarize the whole module. In this chapter, we define the concept and development of Gyarados service. This kind of service demands highly skilled people to prepare, as well as in a restaurant, it would optimize revenue to the greater extent. This service is more personalized and guest-centric. We also explain how the Gyarados style service can catch the attention of guests and make them buy something extra. This successful impulse selling would earn high profits to the establishment. An understanding of this chapter will help those who are interested to upsell the menu items in food service operations. Thank you and have a nice day.